Our manager, Bob, he has a place down in Seabright, New Jersey, and it completely got destroyed. And I think his parents, he sold his old crib to his parents, which is down the area as well, and I think that got destroyed as well.
I lived in Red Bank, New Jersey for the last like 6 or 7 years, and that's one of the places that was pretty heavily damaged as well. I think they just got power recently, and there was like curfews and a lot of stuff. So, I was definitely thinking of a lot of family and friends and neighbors and whatnot.
Have you guys been to the shore? Have you seen the pier down there? Or been to the pier? Or just like, what was your reaction when you first saw like the images on TV, like or on the news?
When I started seeing some of the images from, the damage from Superstorm Sandy, it reminded me of actually some of the damage that we, in upstate New York, we're all upstate from upstate New York, during Hurricane Irene last year, a couple of towns just got wiped out, completely just got flooded out in upstate New York, and that, that reminded me of that, just seeing complete, like, houses just floating down the river, and that brought back a lot of those, horrific moment seeing that in like your hometown. So I know, it feels terrible.
Yeah, it's tough to see.
Yeah.
Was it true that your first debut on MTV was in Seaside?
Yeah.
Is that true?
My first brush with MTV was there used to be a show called Direct Effect that Lala and DJ Clue hosted. And Matt was actually there with me. We went down to Seaside Heights, and I was involved in a rap battle. And it was actually my first time being in New Jersey. And I remember having a great time down there, walking the boardwalk, and we actually went on the what are they called? The cable cars? I don't think they're called cable cars. The ski lift things. Yeah, the ski lifts. And just remember a lot of good memories, and to see the photographs of the effect that this storm had on that, and it makes you step back and think, wow, are things going to be the same, once it's rebuilt? And I don't know, it's tragic, man. I'm sorry. I think it's always, when, you're faced with crazy adversity, and just to see people coming together for a good cause, and although it's such catastrophic, circumstances, people have smiles on their faces and, are working towards a common goal, and I'm going to be up there answering some phones and talking to some kids, so I'm stoked to do my part. We're here for the day. I wish I could stay longer and do more, but
yeah, I think
yeah, like, positive message you could say to people that are still struggling without power, like any inspirations you can give them?
It's tough. I think to everybody out there who's still trying to recover from the terrible hurricane, just stay strong and be close to those who are around you, and I guess just keep your head up, because it will get better. It's hard, but I know that it'll get better.
Donate.
Donate.
We're praying for you.
Absolutely.